Hi, this is Flo, and I'm down here in my end times hideaway. Well, it's been a couple of weeks, and apocalypse hasn't come upon me yet, but I try not to let that discourage me. I'm still waiting down here, and although I have been getting kind of bored, to be honest with you. I kind of miss my cable TV, if you know what I mean. But I've been trying to find some other ways to spend my time, so I've been reading my scriptures a lot. And, well, scriptures say a lot of interesting things, and I try to live by them as much as I can. Now, scripture says that you need to keep your lantern on so that it'll be ready, or it'll be on when the master of the house comes back. And so I've been basically leaving my lights on 24/7. And running up a huge electricity bill, and the Lord hasn't come back yet. But I'm not going to let that discourage me either. I'm just going to keep obeying the scriptures. Now, Jesus said, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anybody opens the door and lets me in, I will come in and dine with him and he with me." And well, I figured if Jesus was on the welcome wagon, I guess I ought to do the same thing. So, although I'm the one who's new to the neighborhood, but I went down to my neighbor's and I knocked on their door. And you'd think he would have invited me into dinner and done the Christian thing, but he didn't. He just kind of closed the door, and I guess I had to just go back home. But I'm not going to let that discourage me either. And I did mention that I have a lot of fruit trees on my property. And as the scripture says, you may eat of any fruit in the garden except for the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. I don't have one of those anyway. So anyhow, I went and ate a little bit of all my fruit. And I ate some red berries, and they gave me an awful stomach ache. I'm not really sure how that fits in with the scriptures, but I'm not going to let that discourage me either. I did have a visit from my nephew, and I'll tell you, children are an awful nuisance. But Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me and do not hinder them." So I figure, well, if Jesus let the little ones climb all over him, I ought to just be a good sport about it and be a good Christian and do the same thing. And as a matter of fact, as pesky as kids are, they're the closest thing you're ever going to see to little angels around here. You look in the face of a child if you want to see the face of God. That's what I think. Although you best not let them near your good china, if you know what I mean. So I've been waiting down here for the end times and trying to keep my spirits up by reading the scripture and putting on the armor of God. And even if the end times doesn't come right away, you can't sit there and live in fear every moment of the day. You just got to keep up your faith and, you know, stay in touch with the people that are around you and stay close to them and be thankful for what you have, because the Bible talks about thankfulness too. So be thankful for your pesky kids and your nosy neighbors and your fruit in the garden, even if it gives you a stomachache, because these are all the things that the Lord has provided to you in the meantime. And then eventually the world's going to end, and then we'll find out what happens then. But in the meantime, just be thankful for what you have and stop living in fear, for God's sakes.